Welcome to my channel. I am Payel and I really hope you are all safe and with your loved ones in whichever part of the world you are. I know we cannot travel right now, but that doesn't stop us from watching travel videos, does it? As you have already read the title, this is all about 10 things to do in Dubai in a day. Now, if you don't want to hear my blabbering, then you can quickly jump to the video. I'll put the timestamp somewhere here. But if you don't mind me here, here's the background. I went to India in the month of January and I had 18 hours long transit in Dubai. My flight landed in Dubai at 7 in the morning and my next flight to Calcutta was at 2 in the next morning. So basically, I had the whole day to explore Dubai. And the reason I was able to squeeze in so many places in a day was because I met a friend of mine who lives there and she showed me around. I really wanted to experience the Dubai safari, but I had to choose between all of these 10 things and the safari because it takes a lot of time. And since it was my first time in Dubai, I went with this. So without any further ado, let's get to the video. This is my list of 10 things to do in Dubai if you were here just for a day or on a transit. Number 1. Explore the souks. If there's one area in any city that attracts me the most is the older part. So even in Dubai, I went to the old Dubai first and explored the souks. There are many souks or markets in old Dubai, but the most popular ones are the gold souk and the spice souk. And once you are there, you will be transported to the beautiful old world of Arabia. The fragrance of the spices, the crowd, the vibe is totally different from the new Dubai, and this is something you should definitely experience. Abra ride. The Abras are very common in Dubai in both the parts, but it's a lot cheaper in old Dubai. You can take one of those public ones to cross the creek, or if you want, you can even hire a private one. Once you cross the creek, you will reach the historical center of Dubai, also known as Al Fahidi. If visiting museums is your thing, you should definitely visit Dubai Museum. The next thing was one of the things that was really looking forward to in this trip, and that is trying the local cuisine. I can travel miles for food. And when you are in old Dubai, try one of the authentic Arabic restaurants with the amazing Middle Eastern cuisine. Now that you're done with all the way, it's time to go back to downtown. Number 5 is take a stroll in Dubai Marina. I didn't have a lot of time here, but how much of a time I had, I tried to explore the place, take a stroll, and I absolutely love the vibe. The next thing was actually quite cool. We took a monorail ride to go to the edge of the Palm Jumeirah Island, and it was quite fun. Number 7. Visit one of the public beaches. Since morning, we were traveling from one place to the other and we really needed to relax for some time. So we went to one of the restaurants and sat there for some time. And of course, we had the beautiful view of Burj Al Arab. Clichés are cliché for a reason. If you come to Dubai, you must go to Burj Khalifa. The best time would probably be the sunset. It was definitely crowded and I had to pay extra to book a slot, but it was all worth it. Chasing sunset colors from 125th floor was amazing. After sunset, you have the hourly fountain show. We were there for a really long time, so we watched it from I think almost every angle. Shopping, explore the Dubai Mall and shop your heart out. I didn't shop a lot because I already had a lot of luggage, but yeah, next time I'm there, I'm definitely going to shop more, and of course I'm going to experience the Dubai Safari. And that's it for the video. If you want me to add anything to my list, please let me know in the comment section, and I'll see you soon. Hopefully the world will be a lot better then. Let's hope so. This too shall pass. Bye.